The Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast. Worksheet level names. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. We're kind of on a streak here talking about name ranges, and you know, one of the things that I discovered is that you can run into a lot less problems with names if you use worksheet level names instead of workbook level names. So if I would just create a name right here, it's going to become a workbook level name and it's available all the time. But with worksheet level names, it's only available on this worksheet. Okay, so here I am on the January report, but I know I'm going to have sheets for Jan, Feb, Mar, April, May. I'm going to have 12 sheets by the end of the year, and I want them all to have the same names. Now, rather than have to go into formulas, define name, and choose worksheet as the scope, check this out. You can actually come here and type Jan exclamation rev, if we want to call that revenue, and then here type Jan exclamation COGS for cost of goods sold, and then here Jan GP. All right, so what I've done is I've created some worksheet level names. So here we'll put in 1,000 here, 800 there, and then the formula revenue minus cost of goods sold, right? So the formulas are working. We just come here and say equal rev, you know, it all works. But if I go to another sheet and type equal RE, there is no named range that it knows of there. Now, if I needed to, I could still say equal Jan exclamation rev and it would work. But I'm now free to come here and call this Feb exclamation rev and Feb exclamation cost of goods sold and Feb exclamation GP. Now, of course, if you have spaces in the worksheet name, then you have to put apostrophes around the worksheet name before the apostrophe here, but it'll work out, and you always end up with worksheet level names instead of workbook level names. Usually what happens is we create the names here on January, and then we control drag to make a copy for March, and then we have one set of workbook level names and one set of worksheet level names, and it's just this big mishmash. Let's just take control of the thing, create worksheet level names from the get-go, especially if we're going to have all of these worksheets with identical names. Thought that was a great tip. Thanks to Dan, one of the PMs on the Excel team, for that heads up with that tip. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.